Hello friends, in this session we are going to take up question 11 to 15 of class 8 Aryabhatta paper 2020 section B. So let's look at this question. 2 raised to power 21 plus 1024 raised to power 2 plus 16 raised to power 6 is divisible by. So first of all, looking at this expression, we need to first find out, can it be simplified to be able to solve it? So we know that 1024 is nothing but 2 raised to power 10. So we can write it, 1024 raised to power 2 can be written as 2 raised to power 10 raised to power 2 plus 16 can be written as 2 to the power 4 whole raised to power 6. So this becomes 2 to the power 21 plus 2 to the power 20 plus 2 to the power 24. Now from this we can clearly take out 2 to the power 20 common. So this becomes 2. 2 to the power 21 is nothing but 2 into 2 to the power 20. So here is 1 and here we get 2 to the power 4. So this is 2 to the power 20 into 2 plus 1 plus 16. So this is nothing but 19 into 2 to the power 20. So now out of the given option, this is clearly divisible by 19. So 19 is the answer, option B. Moving to the next question, in the given figure, angle ADE and ABC differ by 15 degree. Then the measure of angle CAE. So we are given this angle and this angle differ by 15 degree. And what we have to find out is angle CAE. So this is the angle. Let's draw this as. So this is the angle that we have to find out. So now, angle ADE is equal to angle, if we join B and E also, angle ABE. Why? Because we know that angle subtended by an arc in the same segment are equal. You can refer to a separate video which is theorems on circle, which talk about this theorem, which explains this theorem in detail. So going by that logic, we say that angle A, going by this theorem, we are saying that angle ADE is equal to angle ABE. Whereas it is given that angle ADE minus angle ABE is equal to 15 degree. Sorry, ABC. Why are we assuming that ADE minus ABC is 15? Why not other way around? Because clearly from the diagram we can see that ABE is more than ABC and ABE is nothing but ADE. So this implies angle ABE minus angle ABC is equal to 15 degree. We've done nothing but we've just put in 2, we've replaced ADE by ABE from 1. Right? So now, again using the same theorem, we know that angle, this first of all, this would imply that angle CBE is equal to 15 degree, right? So now we taking CE as the arc and angle CAE, which is an angle subtended by this arc on the circumference, will be equal to angle CBE, again by the same theorem. So this would imply that angle CAE is 15 degree, and this is what we had to find out. So option D is the right answer. So moving to the next question, how many twin prime numbers are less than 100? So what are twin prime numbers? Twin prime numbers are pair of prime numbers which have a difference of 2. Okay, so right, 3 and 5 would be a twin prime number set. 2 and 3 would not be, because they are not separated by each other by 2. So let's find out twin prime numbers less than 100. So first pair is 3, 5. Then we have 5, 7. Then we have 11, 13. Then we have 17, 19. Then we have 29, 31. We have 41, 45. Sorry, 41, 43. 45 is not a prime number. 59, 61. 71, 73. So, these are the twin prime numbers less than 100. So let's count them. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. So option B is the answer to this question. So we have 8 twin prime numbers less than 100. Moving to the next question. The maximum possible product of 4 different integers, each of which has a value between minus 5 and 6, both inclusive, is... So first of all, if we have to find out the maximum product, first of all, it has to be positive, right? Because if we get a negative product, it will not be the maximum. So first of all, it has to be positive. Now for the product to be, product of four numbers to be positive, what are the options? First is all four integers are positive. This is first option. The second option is all four integers are negative. And the third option is two are positive and two are negative. Right? So these are the three options. Now for the product to be maximum, what are the options? We have to have, not options, I would say, what are the conditions? First condition that we mentioned is that it has to be positive, for which we have written these three options. The second have to be the magnitude of integers which are being multiplied should be maximum. Right? So now if we take four integers, all positive, what are the maximum magnitudes that we can get? We can get is 3, 4, 5 and 6. If we take all negative, we can get minus 2, minus 3, minus 4 and minus 5. If we take 2 positive and 2 negative, we have 5 and 6 and minus 5 and minus 4. So the product here will be how much? 360. The product here is how much? 120. And the product here is 600. Without even finding the product, we clearly saw that these are the maximum values of the integers. The absolute, the magnitude of the integers is maximum in these this case. So the product is 600. The answer would be 600, option C. Moving to the last question of this session. X is the product of all integers from 300 to 400. So let's write it down simultaneously. X is equal to 300 into 301 into 302 till 400. Both inclusive. So we have included 300 and 400. Why is the product of all integers from 300 to 401? Both inclusive again. So can we call this as 401 into x? Y is nothing but 401 into x. Now we have to find out the value of 1 by x plus 1 by y, which is nothing but 1 by x plus 1 by 401 x. So we can take out 1 by x common and we get 402 by 401 here. Right? So this is the answer, which is nothing but option D. Right? So 1 by x plus 1 by y is equal to 402 by 401 into x in the denominator. Friends, if you like the video, please like it and share it with your friends and subscribe to our YouTube channel to get updates on the new sessions.